Hello and welcome to the basic guide to GemTD Reborn. I'll try and explain how GemTD works. So this is the character selection. Just pick a hero you'd like. It does not matter what hero you'll pick. All have the same basic functionalities. So let me just take Drow Ranger for example. The other two guys have picked already, and now after you're in game, you have to wait 30 seconds, and before that you can't even start building. So you see, we don't have any abilities now. Just wait the time, and it is important that everybody is connected before the minute or the second zero hits. After that, if you connect, you may have trouble or the game will bug out for you. So, okay. This guy here is doing some weird shit. Never mind. Here is how really how you should build the basic maze. Ah, okay. Let me just keep on going here, and I'll explain after the first selection. So everybody can build up to 5 towers, and I was lucky and I had 3 towers, so a B1, a D1 and an Epsilon 1, who just merges into a silver, and I could go with the silver right ahead. Okay, he seems to not get the game. And the basic idea is that you combine the towers of all 3 or 4 players, and that you try to build those in the middle, so you can get those flying enemies out of the way. Every tower. Okay, he knows it slightly different than what we do. Okay, I'll just build 3 towers here, so we have a straight line, and it's important that the arrow is on the down side. And I'll just complete this part, and after that we have to finish there. Okay, here the other guy has an R2, sorry, I have an R2, and he has an R1, and I'll check the formula for you. So if you have a P1, we can build an ST-rated Ruby, and that is upgradable to a Volcano later on. It's very useful to have an asteroided ruby early on, so you can kill the Invis wave, the wave number 8, without having an E1 tower, so that's an opal. Oh, by the way, I call all the towers. Just a moment. We have to complete here first.
Very well.
I'll explain the basic maze as I go along. So we build right on the path that is shown on the texture.
My bow is drawn.
And what I'm doing here is I try to put at least one tower in the middle that is useful, maybe for a direct merge or for use later on. I'll go with the he's going with the B1 and I'm going with the Epsilon 1, so we can actually combine those to a silver in the middle. You've seen the B1 and here the D1 tower just disappeared. That's because all 3 of us play together and the towers are mergeable Oh, yeah, here's another merge. So you've seen the P1, the R1 and the R2 are combined into an austriated ruby. That's this one. And this tower creates a basic Aura who is burning for 15 damage, gives 15 nearby enemies 0.5 damage per second. Okay. And what's important is that the Austriated is not stackable. So if you have two Austriated together, that won't work. Yeah. Just go with the basic towers. So he built a D2. That's useful for the Malachite, and I've gotten myself into two P2 towers and a B1, E1 and G1, and I have to select one, and I will go with the E1 because it's wave 3 and we have plenty of time until wave 8 comes along. Wave 8 is an invisible wave, and only the E towers, so broken opal, E1 or E2 or E3, etc., are able to detect the invis clauses. And also, the invis towers are buffing the other towers around them, so you can see there is a modifier activated. So let me just see what we've got here. Oh, okay, I've got an Epsilon 2 and I've got it twice, and I can upgrade it. So this is the merge button, this is the select button. If you have two of the same pair, so it needs to be Epsilon 2 and Epsilon 2. Epsilon 1 and 2 does not work. Let me see. Okay, and you can merge those. So this is the furthest away you want to be from the middle. And after you have built the basic layout, so here comes another tower, that's where the cross is, 3 by 3 square, and after that you put one tower at each middle part, and that's the basic maze. I'll start the advanced basic maze on the bottom. Okay, I've got an R2, let me just check this first. I have to look what to build, so I've an R2, Epsilon 2, D2, R1 and a B1, and I just look at the table what is useful of those towers. At the moment I won't be able to combine anything, but I'm heading for more silvers, silver knight, and maybe another austeriated ruby. Okay. We've upgraded the middle part again, another Malachite. Okay, the other guys will continue the middle maze. You can actually remove stones and rebuild them, but be careful not to misclick. Well, you can't remove towers, You can only remove stones, but you can misclick and close a certain part of the path if somewhere else the path is open. Okay. He gets the P1. Let me see. Okay, that's for us to create it. I don't have an epsilon 1 and 2, but I have an E2. Is that anything useful for now? Not really. So I go with the Q2, and you see the P1 can be combined, and now we have two asterated rubies together that won't stack. Yeah, we have to upgrade one of those into a volcano so they actually stack. Same auras do not stack, different auras do stack. Different auras of the basically the same tower, just an upgraded version, stack.
So be it.
Okay, I will replace the middle part again to maybe get lucky. Not really the case. And I will just continue the outer maze and check the table again. So we have a B1, P1, E1 and two G1s. Two G1s can be combined or merged into a G2, but they are not very useful at the moment because I don't want too much malachites. They will be useless later on. So I'll just build a B1. Oh, actually, the B1 has a slow 1 aura, or a slow 1 modifier, and the silver has a slow 2 modifier, so they actually stack. You can put a B1, a B2 and a B3, for example, in the middle, and all three will apply a different slow, and all three will stack. Two B1s, so 2 times the slow 1 does not stack, but different slows stack. And the same goes for example, the modifier, the buff here, Aura 2 and Aura 1, for example. And you want to have different slows in the middle, because the boss is really hard, or at least the first boss is super hard. And if you don't have anything to slow him down, you won't get very far. Oh yeah, nice. A Q3 has already been built. So if you ask yourself, why don't I get a Q3 or a D2 at the start? That's because the hero has a level, and you actually level every time you kill creeps. And if, for example, your hero hits level 2, you can build towers, or luck towers, better say, up to level 2. Let me just check here. Oh shit. I could actually have built the B2 in the middle, and I've just missed that. So now the basic maze is almost complete, and I've opened here so I can close on this side, and the creep waves have to pass the middle part around 6 times, and that's the most you can get out of this. And it's the desired basic maze. So if anybody refers to the basic maze or the standard maze, that's what he means. Okay, let me just check again. Can we use a Q one? No. What have I built here? A D one. I'll go with the Epsilon one in the middle. Okay, now we have three silvers in the middle, and you can see the first boss. And I've made another mistake. That's because I speak and play. Okay, the first boss is actually really hard, and it takes a lot of HP, as you have seen, but that's not really a super problem. Had it once. You have to have a silver knight, so that's the upgraded version of the silver. And maybe some other luck towers to stop the first boss. What's the problem here? Ah, okay, no problem. Do we need another B1? Maybe B1 is the most useful out of them, because it will slow enemies down. So the bad luck is not really so bad. You could have worse towers than this. And you see how the game works, and you can scroll down on the formula tab. The plan for now is to get a volcano, to get a quartz and a jade. With the quartz and the jade, you can combine those two into a lucky Chinese jade. The lucky Chinese has actually a chance of restore HP, and that's very useful. Also, the quartz and later on the lucky Chinese have the ability to slow down boss enemies by 100 movement speed, and that's really useful and necessary. So you'll want those as soon as possible. And after that, it's just trying to get other towers. Some of them will apply a really, really good speed buff to your towers, and others will increase the damage and other things. Okay, let me just check again. Maybe the P1, I don't think so. The Q2. Good enough. Okay. So I can combine this one. Okay. Now, some of the towers, as you see, have attack bonus, and that's just attack damage bonus. It's at the beginning 10%, and after that 20%, and so on. So every 10 enemies a tower kills, he gets the modifier increased by 10%. And if I upgrade this silver tower, this one, into a silver knight, so that's the next version of this tower, it will actually take the bonus with it. So it's desirable to have a strong tower at the start, so let's say a Malachite or a silver knight, and to try to feed him the creep kills so he can level up and later on get really strong. Okay, I hope I've built an R1, R2. Let's hope for another R2. Because an R3 will get us a silver knight. Oh shit. Okay, no R3. Let me see. Okay, we can upgrade the Malachite afterwards, because he built an Epsilon 3, so that's the last tower we needed for a huge Malachite. And now I have to select one of my towers. The R2 is only really useful for austerated ruby, and as I said, you don't want more than one austerated, because they don't stack, or you build one at the top and one at the bottom.
Onward.
Okay. So that's another Malachite that is merged in or combined into a better tower. The Epsilon 1 here is gone.
The price you pay.
You could actually upgrade the Epsilon 1, and the Malachite in the middle would be gone, and the huge Malachite would be where the Epsilon 3 is. So you can choose the position of the towers. As you see, the basic creep waves are not really a problem. They have to go through the middle part 6 times. I'll explain the maze shortly. So the creeps start at the top here. They have to reach the point 1 first, then the point 2, then the point 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 6 is the actual gem castle. Let us try again. Okay.
My bow is drawn.
So what do I have? An E3. E3 is useful for Jade and also for the buff. So I'll go with this, because the other towers don't really have anything useful at the moment. B2 is not really useful at all, or just for a really special tower down here. So I'll go with the Epsilon 3. And now you can see here is another buff, Aura 3. And if you check the huge tower, just a second, Epsilon 2. Is that really useful? So, okay, back to the Opal. So, this is Aura 3, and if you check the huge Malachite, he has the modifier of this tower. And here is Aura 2. It should, in theory, get the aura from that tower too. Maybe they changed the auras of the opal, that you only have the best aura. That could be a possibility. Yeah, looks like it. Okay, and you see these bulldogs are actually more tanky than before the other waves. After the first boss, the waves get stronger. After the second boss, the wave gets even stronger. And we are three people. I don't think I've told that already. We are three people, so the game will adjust for that. If we are four, it will, the enemies will be stronger. If one of the team players leave, the waves will get a bit easier, so you can actually play this game solo. You can see the ranking, and here are all the top players. So 4 player, 3 player, 2 player and 1 player, and which wave they managed to kill, and they have all passed, so not much of an improvement possible there. You can see how much damage they did to all the bosses combined. If I push enter, you can see boss damage is almost 2000 so far, and it will add up. The next boss will take a lot more damage, and that will add up to this number here. And if we would actually make it to the end of the tower defense and have enough points, we would be in the ranking, in the top ranking list. Oh, Epsilon 3 there. Okay, let me see. He has an R3. I get the Epsilon. Oh shit, it's only a 2. So that's not really useful. I'll get it anyway. No. Where is Epsilon 2 actually? That's not really useful anywhere so far. So let's just build the Q1. Okay, I need to upgrade, maybe, because the wave is really strong. And I've upgraded this tower to a Silver Knight, and it actually has the modifier it earned before, so 30%. 30% attack speed, attack damage, sorry, and it does 60 damage plus 17. That was my thought. And that's one of the basic strategies. You try to upgrade the already formed towers. In the next wave we'll hit level 4 and it will be possible to go up to towers of level 4, so that's a B4 and R4 and so on. R2 is no real use. Let me see. B2 and 3 are already there. E2, is that of any use? Not really. Oh man. Okay, no real. Oh, wait. A G1 maybe? So we can build another Malachite. So what does he have? Okay, he goes for the B3, and B3 will be useful for uranium to 38, and that will be combinable to uranium to 35. Those two are multi-shot towers and are really useful. You can see huge malachite and malachite with uranium is combined to an even better uranium, and it will, I think, hit up to 15 targets. So that's a desire for later. We'll need an Epsilon 5 for that, and it's not really common to get an Epsilon 5 anytime soon. So let's stick to our Volcano, Quartz and Jade. Okay. So no real problem here. You can see that they have managed to go up to arrow number 3, so there are two more to pass, and we are not in any danger anytime soon for the basic creeps. The only hard part will be the next boss that will hit us level 20. Before that, at level 18, there is another wave of invisible creeps, and that should not be any problem because we have a lot of invis detection towers there. Every 10 waves after the first wave number 8, there is an invis wave, so that's wave number 8, wave number 18 and 28. Yeah, go with the 3, and we need an D1. And upgrade to B2. And upgrade here as well to a silver. Let me see if there's anything else open for upgrade. Not really. Okay, we've managed to get a Jade tower, and it applies poison damage that lasts over 5 seconds, and it's 10 damage per second. And if you can't really kill a wave that easily, you want to hit each target once, so you can actually control the tower and tell him to hit each creep. So you have to click each creep and apply the poison damage. Okay, this wave is not a problem as well. You can see they have a little bit more HP left than the previous wave, or not even that. Yeah, maybe the upgraded tower just helped us keep on pace with the strength gain of the creep waves. What do you not want? That's easy. You don't want basic towers like Epsilon 1, B1, B2 and so on to clutter up the middle part. You need the middle part for the big towers, so just try to get one useful tower in the middle So, for example, if you want a silver in the middle, you build one of the three in the middle, B1, D1 or Epsilon1, and the other two you use for the maze, to extend the maze. And after you have all three of them, you can just build the silver in the middle, the other two will be disappearing and be replaced by a block, by a normal block. Okay, we have an Epsilon 5, what the fuck? Okay, that was really lucky. Let me see where we will build the tower. Or first off, let's see what I have here. Something useful? Not really. So I'll go with the Epsilon 1 for another silver. Okay. So middle. Okay, uranium needs B3 and E2. So do we have an B2 or E3 in the middle? Not really. Upgrade again. Oh, nice. Okie dokie. So you can see the huge malachite just upgraded into a uranium. And let me see, it hits 10 enemies for 70 damage. And with the attack damage bonus of 10%, it's 77 damage. That's really good. And with another malachite and another Epsilon 5, we actually have two uraniums. And that's the last tier of the multi-shot towers, as far as I know. Okay, let me just see what I can build. Oh, Epsilon 4. D3 and a P something. P3.
Yes.
Okay, that looks promising. The other player here has an R3. Epsilon 4, is it anything desirable? So let's see what the other guy builds. That's a P3, so that's useful for volcano. And I'll just get that one. And we need an R4 and a G4 for the volcano and the quartz. After we got the G4, we can build a quartz. We can also build a Yade again, I see, and we can build a Lucky Chinese. So where to build the Yade? Okay, we'll save the one for Yade, for quartz. Don't up, okay. Yeah, you see this uranium tower, the lasers are all from the uranium tower and they hit pretty hard. That's what you want. But the problem is this tower is not really useful for the boss because it's multi-target, so it has less damage than the single target towers. And will hit multiple creeps. And the boss wave is always just a single creep. I'll just continue to build here so our uranium can hit the wave longer. Okay, I've got a Q3. Is that anything I can use? Not really. Or maybe down here. No, not really. So what do we need? Maybe. Oh, we could build another silver with the R3, but the R3 is already needed for the quartz, so don't upgrade the silver or you'll lose the R3 for the quartz. Okay, he just built a G3. Ooh, Epsilon 3 and B4. Nice. So let's see what could be useful anytime soon. Okay. Oh shit. That will probably kill us. That's because we don't we haven't managed to get a lucky Chinese or a quartz. A quartz would be enough. And the quartz is a must get. You see those 8000 HP, were too much because we did not have a quartz or a lucky yade. Forward. So be it. Anyway, keep on building. Sometimes you have bad luck, but you can still build to get used to everything. P3 is useful for the volcano. Anywhere else? Here, bloodstone, okay. We'll get that one. And nothing particularly useful there. So let's just go with the G1 maybe. To get another malachit. And we could use new B towers for additional slow. Yeah. P towers are actually really useful against the boss because they remove armor and that will significantly increase the damage output of the other towers. So we need a G4 for the lucky Chinese. Again, if you can't memorize the basic maze, you want on the left, you want the block to be above, on the right you want the block to be under, on the top you want the block to be on the left, and on the bottom you want to be it down under, but start with the three top arrows and build afterwards the bottom line.
That was my thought.
Ooh, what do we have here? A G3? Okay. Or an Epsilon 3? Or a D3? Ooh. B4 and D3? R2, okay. So, where do we need a G3? For the lucky Chinese, as it looks like, and the Epsilon 3 is used, I think, for the huge Malachit, so no real use there. We already got a Epsilon 3, and the D3 is used, I think, down here somewhere. Okay, D3 is already okay. Just go with the Epsilon 3, maybe, or maybe not. And as you see, I consider all the simple towers to be worthless, so don't really get too excited if you have D3 on its own. It does only 18 damage and is significantly less important than a combined. So just a silver tower, that's a D1, Epsilon 1 and B1, does more damage than a single D3. So don't try to just get the most out of the basic 5 towers you build by merging them, because they won't be useful for the actual purpose of beating the game. If that makes any sense, what I told. Oh, and now after wave 20, you see they have a lot more HP and are remarkably harder to kill, and it will actually get really hard soon, so I expect us to make it to maybe wave 25, or if we are lucky, to 26. Oh, and the slow hits pretty hard. We can slow with 3 different slow auras, as you can see. And that slows the, especially the boss, extremely hard. That's because we have a B4 tower there. A silver is B2, or slow 2. And B3 is there too. Maze. Looks pretty solid so far. We were a bit unlucky to not have a quartz yet. But hey, it's okay. And we do still need a volcano, so an R4 is needed immediately. Okay, it's getting hard. That's the second last checkpoint. And after they've reached this point, they have to pass just one more time.
Very well.
We may hit level 5 after this wave. No, we don't. Too bad. I think we would be level 5 if we had killed the boss.
My bow is drawn.
Yeah, I'll go with the Epsilon 3. That's the only useful tower there. D4? Oh, can we use that one? A D5 would be useful. D4, yeah, it's useful for the black cat's eye. Oh, D4 or Q4? Q4? Where is that needed for the bloodstone? As far as I know, the dark emerald or the bloodstone, one of the two. Are super hard buffs that will buff all nearby towers, but only in a small radius. Do we have anything to combine besides the Silver Knight? Not really. Okay, and you can see they have a lot of armor.
Tastes so sweet.
And they get slowed pretty hard. In case you're wondering, the gold is there for nothing at the moment. They might add something to use the gold for in the future, but I haven't read anything about that for now. Shiny Q5, nice. Oh, nice. E4 and G2. Okay, let me see. Oh, nice. So all the enemies in this radius do have armor removed by 15. That's pretty strong. So we actually just need a gold tower, and with that we would have elaborately carved tourmaline. Oh shit, yeah, that might be our last wave. Okay, we managed to stay alive. One more wave. Nothing of any use. I built the D3 because we already got D4s. Ah, sorry. Okay, I've made a mistake. But no problem there. And Q5 is not really useful. Yeah, that's it. And good game.
Lost. You should know that I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed at how furious I am at you for losing.
Okay, and that's it. I hope you learned something and you understand the game now. If not, just keep asking in the comments below. Thanks for watching.